Yeah, you, blue jeans, blue jeans, with the starch. Come here, babe, come sit next to me. Come and take your drawers off. Damn, you on the edge of the bed, you about to fall off. Take your blicky, sit in right next to my blicky on the dry seat. He put his hand on my coochie and he told me that I'm pressure. Let me sip my drink before I spill my drink. Damn, you look so good, that dick I wanna taste. Now we fucking raw, we don't got shit to say. I sat down on top of him and put my coochie in his face. Let's fuck, let's fuck, let's fuck, let's fuck. What's up, what's up, what's up, let's fuck. Let's fuck, let's fuck, let's fuck, let's fuck. What's up, what's up, what's up, let's fuck. Dig me down, you wanna beat my doonies down? I love fucking on these niggas, I like fucking bitches. I love how you fuck me, I love how she eat me out. Come here, baby, let me show you how this coochie hittin'. Come here, baby, let me show you what this coochie do. I love you and all the love freaky things you do. He my favorite eater, he gon' trade my coochie juice. Baby, eat me out.
Let's fuck, let's fuck, let's fuck, let's fuck. What's up, what's up, what's up, let's fuck. Let's fuck, let's fuck, let's fuck, let's fuck. What's up, what's up, what's up, let's fuck.
Me not. The trap terror minister makes sure you never have to worry nor wonder. Clary is just a click away.
Hi, come on, it's your girl P, the trap terror minister, your favorite psychic on the tube, and we're back with another reading. Today we're going to be discussing this hot topic for this windy Wednesday. Is that motherfucker you asking about your friend for real seats, or are they faking a bitch? So yeah. You guys chose Rock Data. So for you guys, I feel like this person here could be, for some of you guys, this person could be psychic or they're real connected, either through socials, or this person could just be popular to some degree. Either they're popular in their community. Some of you guys, they're popular in a sense to where I'm hearing plug talk. So this person could be, they could be very sociable. They could be networked. Who were networkers. This person could be popular since to where maybe they were in the military, so they traveled a lot. This person could be popular since to where they have a platform, they're psychic, or they're a content creator, something like that. This is a musician or something like that, or something like this person here. They're whatever they do for a career or what they're known for is put in the forefront, okay? This is definitely somebody who has a public presence. And I think this person here, this could be somebody where they're, although they're public, their content could be a little bit off-putting to some people. So some people might look at this person's content or the work that this person do or the art that this person produces. What separates them from other content creators is that I feel like it's very niche. Like, let's just say this person here is, like I said, like a psychic. There are people who don't agree with what we do. Some people, they demonize our gifts and things of that nature or whatever. But that's neither here nor there. That's an example that I'm reading. But another example would be this person could be a rap artist and they could make controversial music. For others of you, I'm getting an energy of this person could definitely... I think this person here... Something about this person offering, I think a lot of people, this person could be very sensual, for instance. Like, say this person has OnlyFans, it might not be everybody's cup of tea. This person's always focused on sexual content. Or if this person curses a lot, it's something like that. Or if this person is a mother and they post, they don't have to be nothing crude. It could just be something where it's very niche, where it's only appeals to a certain demographic of people. But people within their community could be aware of who they are. They have a target audience, is what I want to say. I would also say that with Arcturians, I would say that this person here certainly is someone who tries, they probably don't talk a lot about what they have going on in their life, but they want you to vent a lot about what you have going on, okay? I feel like this person here with a Turing, but I only pulled two cards for you guys so far, just to get the energy. I asked, is this person your friends? I would say that this person here, right now I'm not really getting this person's around. I feel like they want you to think that they're a friend. I feel like this person here, they say things like, you can trust me, you can trust me, you can trust me. I always get weary around people who say stuff like that, because not saying you can't trust those people, because they're telling you what they want you to think, and you can't do those tactics on me, because I've already experienced it. This is definitely somebody who's into that. I'm hearing, hello, Clarice. I think this person likes to play mind games. I think this person could be a little bit, I don't know. I think this person has access to certain information that they gatekeep. And I feel like this person here, they might withhold information that you ought to know, or they might keep you at a comfortable distance. This person probably finds you to be more beneficial to be around. They probably know that you're destined to go somewhere, and they probably want to attach themselves to your destiny, but they might not want you to know that. Whether they're a friend or not, I definitely feel like this person here has opportunist characteristics. They're very attractive, though. Whoever this person is, they're very cute. They could like wearing the colors pink and green, or they could be very vain. This person's very, they're very vain. They're very weight conscious. They're very conscious about their appearance. They're very vain. They probably think that everything is about them. Right? You're so vain. You probably think the sun is about you. You're so vain. This person here could be someone that gossips. Like they like to gossip. Okay. They've definitely spilled some tea to you. Like, you and this person have had messy conversations before. When you and this person talk, I feel like even if it is uplifting, it's kind of at the expense of someone else. You guys probably haven't had a conversation where it hasn't involved the downputting of someone else. So, from what I'm getting right now, I would say no. Even if they are friends to you, I would feel like this isn't a quality friendship. But I digress. Let's see. Is this person one's friend? Okay. The Eight of Cups and the Hangman, no. The Death card and the Wheel of Fortune. I think this is somebody who wants to present themselves as your friend. This might be an acquaintance. This person might be, I don't think, see that net? I think this person's a monitoring spirit. I think this person, again, they know that you're destined for something. They know that you're going places, and I feel very strongly that this person here is waiting on the right time. Like, I think this person's an opportunist, is what I want to say. They're definitely opportunists. This person sees something in you that you don't see in yourself, and they may have stuck their neck out for you, in a sense, to where trying to get your attention. They're nosy too, and they can't keep their mouth closed. I feel like this person here, they bottom jaw is made of water, is what they're saying. Nine of Cups on the bottom of the deck. This person here probably is very attractive. They looks can be deceiving, is what I'm getting, because her eyes are red in this card. I don't think that you have to treat this person as an enemy. I just don't feel like this is like somebody that's meant to be. I think that you should disconnect from this person. But I feel like the way this person is, you're going to have to disconnect from this person like slowly. Because they're reactive, I feel. I think this is somebody who does things for people to get. They're kind of a little bit like psychotic. Like, this is somebody who may, in a weird way, I feel like this person may have gifts. But they might. This is somebody who will say prayers for people. And this is a divination abuser. That's what I want to say. Like, this person would like. They speak negative things over people, or they overthink, or they obsess over people, and then that way they put spells on people because they think negative things are going to happen to people when things don't go their way. So they try to manifest chaos in people's life because they perceive everything as a personal attack when it's not that. It's like, bitch, you're just not their cup of tea. It's not that people. It's just like the type of confirmation. Okay, so I watched a reading by the Ghetto Nun, and I was like, who is she talking about? But now I know exactly what she's talking about. Or someone, I forget what reading I was watching, she was like, someone is going to be saying like, oh, this person can't handle a real one. They don't know what it's like to handle real people. You have to be careful with people who say shit like that, because 9 times out of 10, they are everything but real. And it's not that everybody can't handle real motherfuckers. They just smell the apparent overbearing smell of shit on you. Because you be full of shit, like, you know? They be full of shit. And they try to present themselves as, like, being knowledgeable. I feel like this person here, they might teach you things, but in the way they tell you things, it's kind of like to talk down on you. And I really feel like this person here, they recognize you as being knowledgeable and intelligent. And I think this person here, you're a lot smarter than this person. They probably try to emulate your energy back to you. Okay? I think this is somebody that you met through social media. This person here could be intimidated by you. Okay? I think this is somebody here who, I think they probably had intention. I think they like you though. in a sense. I think you're a likable person. I think you're very innocent. I think you're very naive. And I think that this person here, they can learn a lot from you. They have learned a lot from you. And I think this person looks at you as somebody they can teach them things. So this person probably looks at you in a sense to where an opportunity. This person probably does the same thing as you, right? But they probably don't get the reach that you get because they're not as personable. They're probably not as genuine as you are. And they're definitely not as gifted as you are. I think that this person might be smart. They might be gifted, but they don't have the gifts that you possess. And this person might think that if they help you out in some degree, if they get their, they get you close enough, they can dictate some things in your life, okay? I think this person here has a, this person's mindset is more, so they're competitive by nature, okay? For some of you guys, this person could be a Virgo, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio, Virgo, Cancer, Aries. I think they can have these placements heavy in their chart. Capricorn, especially Scorpio. Okay, this person here has a darker energy, a darker aesthetic. They can be dark complected. They don't have to be. But I think this person here, something about their energy, I don't know. I'm hearing heebie-jeebies. So this person here could be like goofy. They could like Beetlejuice, or something about this person could like the colors green, because Beetlejuice's hair is green. So this person probably likes to dye their hair green. And even at the card that I'm looking, there's a green alien here. So something about the color green could be significant. This person could like to dance. I think this is somebody who does a lot for attention, and you don't have to work as hard as they do. It probably looks like you do, but you don't. I think this person is inspired by you, but I think this person tries to get a leg up on you. I think this person tries to think about what you're going to do before you do it, and they probably give you bad advice to push things into their favor. I would say no, this person isn't your friend. Let me make sure. The Scrawl Bra Digger. Clarify this person. Four of Cups in the World. Yeah, I think this is somebody here who actually, I think a lot of people actually do like this person. But I think the way they present them, I think this person, this is the type of person who says, oh, this is a feminine energy who says, women don't like me. This is this type of person who says stuff like that, like, women don't like me. Right? And that's very telling. I always look at people crazy when they tell me that, especially women specifically, when you're a woman and you tell me you only get along with men, but you don't get along with no women. No women like you? No women. Or do you surround yourself with women that you feel like are beneath you, or insecure women, so you feel better about yourself, and those women don't like you? But it shouldn't be to where no woman likes to be around you. Like, even when women are jealous of me, women love me. Like, people like me. I'm a lovable person. I might not like them, but people like me. People can't do shit but respect me. You know, and this is like somebody who feels, who says that they don't have no girl, like no homegirls. I'm here at Sausage Party. This person can have Aquarius places in their chart. I think this is somebody here. I don't know, some of you, this person could have done sex work. They definitely do something on the internet. This is World Wide Web here, right? This is definitely the internet. For sure. I think this is somebody here that you probably like at some point hid from your story, blocked or restricted. This is probably somebody where you don't jive with their content. If this person posts content, you probably don't fuck with the content. You probably support it just to be nice, but they're not your cup of tea. I think this person intends to be a friend to you. I think they want to be your friend. I just don't think that you care for them. I think this person, from their perspective, they feel like they've been a friend, but I think that you don't like this person like that. That's really what it is. I think that they're not your friend in the sense to where you probably are thinking like, okay, is this my friend? Because you probably want to like convince yourself to like this person, but you don't have to force yourself to like somebody that you just don't jive with. You probably just don't fuck with this person like that. Because like, now that I'm looking at it, these cards really aren't that bad. They just not my, like, it's just the way it looked, the way it laid out to me, I would say no, initially. But now that I'm looking at it, the Nine of Cups, the Eight of Cups, the Hangman, the Death Card, the Wheel of Fortune, the way it's laid out, I would say, actually, the Nine of Cups came after, it was the last card. The way it's laid up, laid out, I would say, like, the Eight of Cups suggests that you don't care for this person, okay? This person probably does a lot to get your attention, and you're probably disinterested. I think this person wants to be a friend. I think this person here, I don't know, something about this energy here, it seems uncomfortable. Yeah, just as I said, look at the bottom of the deck. We have the The Six of Swords, but she's holding a snake. I feel like there's something about wanting to move forward with your person with caution. Like, I think this person, this is someone that you have to feed with a long handle spoon, because this is somebody that, I don't know, this somebody is very emotional. They don't know how to, like, just let things, like, bygones be bygones. I think this person takes a lot of things personal. And now that I'm looking at this death card, it's like, the more, it's like every time I want to go, like, you might go back and forth. Like, this person might be, they're tricky in that way. They shed their skin, they act different, they're finicky. Like, one second this person can do something really genuine and nice, and it can appear real, and you could be like, oh no, maybe I was overlooking, maybe I was tripping. No, you're not tripping, because now that I go back and I look at the same card, I don't know, like, you may have stopped talking to this person and started to back talk to this person. It's like, why did I stop talking to this person again? It's because this person here, they have glimpses where they show you that they're in competition. I think there's somebody there to stomp over other people to get ahead. And look at the card. You know, if that's what it's giving. I think this person here is also somebody who, They're self-serving. They're an illusionist, okay? I think there's somebody here who emulates what they know people want to see. Every time I write these words, they become a taboo. Yeah. This person, I'm hearing he a fan. This person isn't genuine. This is somebody who, it's like, for instance, this is like if I was to do a reading for Kendrick Lamar on Drake long before, like, it happened, you know, long before the conflict, the garage where he had said something on the song or whatever the fuck, whatever. No, actually, I guess Kendrick started it and finished it, actually. But hypothetically speaking, this is like kind of like that energy, like the way he depicts Drake and the way he discusses Drake or the allegations he makes about Drake, allegedly, it's kind of like that type of vibe. Like, this is somebody, a culture vulture. This is somebody who probably, like, they like your aesthetic, they like the way you do something, and they want to repurpose it. It's like, they want to stamp it as theirs. Because I don't know why, but this doesn't look like her true skin. This is like the red eyes. This is like indignant of the snake. Yes, the snake has the same colored eyes. This person's a snake. They can't be trusted. I'm going to trust my intuition on this one. I feel like they can't be trusted. I'm going to pull a card from from this deck, actually. The True Calm Oracle deck. I'm going to see, like, why you can't trust this person. Why this person isn't your friend. Go check out my reading. Can you trust them? I just posted it last week. It's definitely going to be useful for you regarding this person or this connection. Some of you guys, you may have been drawing more than one pal, because this may or may not be the person's edge. I might be picking up on somebody else. This is like somebody where, this person here, they're manipulative, is what I'm gonna say. They're definitely manipulative. Tell me more about, is this person pals my friend? The death card came out twice. And look at this. I don't like the fact that it's the, like, the devil looks energy. It's probably going to be a Capricorn. They have Capricorn placements in their chart. We have man-made disaster in marriage. They can be lusty. They like your lifestyle. This person here, that's why I feel like, this person wants to be inside your life. This person wants to be tied to you. They kind of want your life. I think this person here could be envious in a certain degree. This is the type of person, like, I'm kind of looking at this as, like, I saw Carrie when I looked at this card. Some of these persons could name could be Carrie, or they could be saying, like, they care. This is like the lady, like, y'all ever seen that movie on Netflix called I Care A Lot? It's a lady who presents herself as, like, taking care of older people and being nurturing, but really she just wants to make money. You know, it's that type of energy from this person. Like, no, this person's not your friend. I think this person here, they do their best to finagle to get into people's energy and get close to them. And they could be psychic. They could be really into magic. It's like somebody that'll get you close to them, so they come into your house and drop some, like, juju off in your house or some shit. This is like somebody who likes to tie people up. There's also somebody who will try to, like, sabotage somebody's relationship. This person cannot get along well with people that are close to you. They can sabotage relationships with those that are close to you on purpose. Tell me about why this person isn't a friend of Pile 1. Why isn't this person a good friend for Pile 1? Imprisonment. I think this person likes to keep you stuck. This person probably likes to feed you things like you can only trust them. Like, you can't trust other people around you that have been around you way longer than this person. This person probably tries to create illusions, like, they try to isolate you. and they try to instill doubt. They try to postpone things that you have. They try to give you bad advice, is what I'm gonna say. I think this person has a lack mindset. They fear monger, is what I'm really getting. Like, they try to hang things over your head, like negative things. Okay, and they discount your hard work, money. They're opportunists, like I said. Why isn't this person Power One's friend? Egotism. If it's you or them, they're always going to choose them. And it's not like in a normal sense. I feel like this person here, with homicide, this person's envious. I think this person here, like, I think they need to have an ego dip. And I'm telling you, this person, they want your life. Be careful. This is somebody who could low-key like your relationship or want your relationship. Or this is somebody who would sabotage that. Or, like, this is somebody, this is kind of weird because it's kind of showing me obsessed. This is a person here, they could get really, like, into, like, they can probably be way into you. Or they could, like, I don't know. This person here, they're crazy. Then they're off their fucking rocker. This is, like, showing me when one of my friends tried to, like, literally, she tried to drug me or get me super intoxicated so I could sleep with her husband. And when I stopped talking to her after that, she popped up in my crib on some weird shit. So, it's something like that, you know? Yeah. Power supply. This person here, they're energy vampire. They siphon off of your energy, and when you're not around, they make it a big deal, and they try to hang it over your head. You probably guys could have just met, but they expect you to, like, treat them as if y'all been together or y'all been friends for like ages. Like, this person here, they spaz. This person can hit, like, I don't know, I feel like this person, like, they code switch when they talk to you. This person got schizophrenia or something like that. I'm not a doctor, but with organized crime, I think this person here, they're very calculated. That's why I was getting like, hello Clarice. This person's like a master manipulator, and I think that they overlook into things get convoluted, and when things don't go their way, like, they seek their own justice, you know. And I feel like this person, yeah, caregiver. Go watch that movie, I Care a Lot. That's this person's energy, for real. I'm serious. Like, it's definitely worth the watch, or at least go read up on it on Reddit or something like that. But this person seeks to get their own justice and revenge when people, quote unquote, sabotage them or hurt them. And all the while, I feel like people create distance between them because they can be overbearing at times. They don't know boundaries. And I think this person, they can be nice, but I think this person takes things personal that don't need to be personal. They just do too much when you aren't able to be there for them. They can be very clingy, is what I'm kind of getting. And it's like, this person takes everything as a fucking attack. If it's somebody that'll wish bad things on you or to sabotage something for you, that ain't, and it's like, whole time, we weren't even supposed to be beefing. Like, I don't know. This is weird. But yeah, this will be your reading pile number one. I love you guys for the Looney Bag. And around the whole system, I'll talk to you guys later. Bye. Okay, guys, I'm gonna like this Palo Santo because Power One was kind of like, it was ghetto, honey. So, we're gonna get into some things. I'm gonna clear the energy for you guys. I'm getting a resounding yes so far, low key. Like, in my spirits, I feel like it's a yes for you guys. And I don't think you're just asking about one person. I think you talk about a group of people, or like this, or this person. Or this person could just come with someone else. Like, this person might have kids or something like that. Or this could be family or something like that. I'm gonna be your family, like a giant tree reaching out to the sky. So, yeah, this person here, I feel like this person here, they, this person could offer you advice, you know? But I feel like this would, they have good intentions with you, is what I want to say. I think this person here, they support your creative endeavors as well. You know, I think this is somebody who reposts your stuff. They're not ashamed to see you doing better than them. I think that it inspires this person or these people. I think these people have their, I don't know. This could be like siblings. This might be like a sibling or something like that. Or this person could be like somebody that you had around you so long that it's like, yeah, damn, they're like family. You know, so tell me more about the friendship that Power 2 has with this person or these people on their mind. Y'all, I'm recording. I'm slamming all that shit. I'm recording. Oh, okay.
Tell me more about, is this this person or these people? Tell me about the relationship between Pal Tula, this person, these people. This might be her pal. Might not be cursed pal. This relationship between this person and these people that Pal Tula is inquiring about. The Hermit. You could have known people since school age. Y'all could just not be talking right now. Or maybe y'all are going through a phase where y'all just life is just leading y'all in different directions. Okay. Y'all could be defensive with each other right now. There could be like some underlying. Y'all might not be speaking right now. There might be some tension. It might be some confusion about some things. Miscommunication could have definitely transpired. I could see where this could be a connection that you guys could have initially came together to bond through emotional trauma. Y'all could trauma bond in this relationship. I don't think it's solely based on trauma bond. I think right now y'all are defensive with each other right now. Things might be going haywire. One of these people here has a heart. Well, one person has anxiety and the other person could have like depression, something like that. Like there's like, you guys have something in common. I'm not a doctor, but I'm kind of getting energy surrounding someone here. One person is way easier at masking their emotions than the other, but I feel like you guys balance each other out. One or both of you really like to read those, what is that, Ed Sheeran books? Or was it, no, those poet books. Ah, oh, fuck, not Ed Sheeran. Aaron Sheeran is a fucking musician. Be so fucking for rookie here. Al Silverstein, those books. They could, like, you or this person could really like those books. Al Silverstein, growing up, or y'all could have both, like, bonded over a love for reading. Y'all could like reading together. Y'all could bond over nerdy things. I think that y'all have a lot of common, like, y'all have inside jokes, you and this person. Like, things that only y'all could get, understand? But I feel like y'all relationship is rooted, like, y'all have, like, it's rooted in something. I feel like y'all have a strong foundation. But I feel like it's rooted in like having to come up both in like a tough situation, coming up together and making the best out of something that was very difficult, coming out of something. But right now, you guys could be a different phase of life, and maybe you're trying to reconfigure what this friendship is going to look like now that you guys are no longer living in a traumatic situation. Okay, so that's what I'm getting. But let's see, is this person Paul Chu's real friend? Or these people? Is this really a friend? Is this person really their friend? Okay, the Five of Wands. Okay. 3, 6. The Six of Pentacles and the Temperance. Yeah. I think that there's energy surrounding, like, this person here, they're your friend. But I think that you guys, again, are outgrowing, like, outdated. Like, this person has different priorities right now. But it doesn't mean that you guys aren't like this. I feel like it's more than a friend type of situation with the situation here. This person has other things going on. And it may appear like this person here doesn't prioritize this friendship or like it's a big fuck you. But in due time, you'll understand why but there's distance. I think that this person here, there needs to be some individuality. I think this person needs to be like a perspective of understanding this person has other things going on in their life outside of this friendship that the two of you share. But I would say, yes, this person is your friend. Okay. I think that you guys are just in a rough patch right now. I think that you guys might be in a state where y'all might be bumping heads a little bit more than normal. Y'all might not be like beefing, but y'all might not be as close to what you would remember y'all to be close. And this is just normal. Okay. This is just what happens inevitably when you've been friends with somebody 10 plus years, shit like that. You know, when it gets to this point, it gets kind of mundane, you know, where you're getting to the point where we're grown, we're adults, people having children, their priorities are shifting, things of that nature. So anything else, like is this Pal, is Pal Tula's person their friend? This is the wrong deck to be using for this. But I could already see how yes is the answer. Is Pal Tula's person their friend? And if so, tell me why this person is their friend. Yeah. You guys get along and it's like, it's just very natural for you guys. You guys could also just be family, like y'all could be linked or y'all could be soul family, you know, at the very least. But I think that this is somebody where with white light, they encourage you. They pray for you. This is somebody who wishes good things for you even when you don't ask for it, even when you're not around. And I think that this with infinity, I think that you guys recognize, you guys are soulmates of some degree. Platonic or romantic soulmates. So I would say yes, certainly this is your friend, pile number two. Very short reading, very quick and to the point. This will be your reading. I love you guys to the moon and back. And I'll talk to you guys later. Bye. Bye. Okay.
No discrimination, just pure, genuine prophecy. Real niggas do real nigga shit. Universal guidance tailored for you.
Okay, so, hi there, pal number three. We're going to be getting into the topic. We're going to be discussing, is the person or the people on your mind, are they your real friends? Can you trust the motherfuckers this Windy Wednesday? Okay, now or ever. Okay, so, let's try to administer. Get into it. Thumbs up. Like, share, comment, subscribe. You're going to love it here. Support black business. You have nothing that's stopping you from doing so. It's not going to, they're not going to burst into your house and beat on you and your children if you give a girl a like. Give a nigga a like, damn. Okay, so, boom. Let's get into it. Okay, so I feel like this is something. I think this person here, whether they're a friend or not, I don't know. We're gonna see. But off the rip, I feel like this person here, just like Power One, they bottom jaw is made of water. They are a monitoring spirit. I think this person is nosy, and I think that this person here, just know that whatever you tell this person is going, it's funneling through multiple channels. Okay, I don't think it is stopping there. This person is definitely curious about you. So if you've been withholding information from this person, they've noticed and they want to know what's going on with you. Okay, so yeah. Let's get the fuck into this energy, okay? So, is this person... tell me about the friendship between Pile 3 and the person they're asking about. Tell me about the relationship between Pile 3 and the person they're asking about. Tell me something good. Queen of Swords and the Queen of Wands, okay? Tell me that you love me. Okay, and what is this? The High Priestess in reverse. I'm gonna put the High Priestess back because I just don't, it fell on the floor and I don't know how it's supposed to come out. We have the Queen of Swords and the Queen of Wands. I think somebody set a boundary with somebody. Somebody could have felt iced out by somebody. I think this person is focused on themselves and their creative endeavors. For sure. I think that there's an energy surrounding, there might be somebody here. Clarify the Queen of Swords. Y'all are both bad boss bitches on your own right. Like, y'all are both like, yeah, I don't think it's a need for you guys to compete with each other, but I could see where someone here might be defensive towards the other person. One person might be a little bit intimidated by the other. Okay. One person could be gothic. Maybe more than one person is more intimidating than the other. One person could be outgoing and the other person could be like shy, maybe gothic, maybe have a darker aesthetic, maybe a little bit like introverted. Like, one of you guys could be extroverted, the other person could be introverted. I think that you guys hit it off pretty quick though, okay? For sure. You guys definitely hit it off pretty quick. You guys could both bond off a dance. Y'all could have known each other from a time and period in which you were doing dance, or this person could be a dancer. I think this person has changed their aesthetic drastically. One of both of you has changed your aesthetic drastically. I think that there is an energy surrounding one person. It could be someone that's very sociable, with, like I say, extroverted. One person that a lot of people are connected with, and they can have both of y'all can have a lot in common, but one person is received a little bit better than the other person from others. Like, one could just know how to talk to people, the other person could be like kind of like, I don't know why. Y'all, hold on, guys. I'm so annoyed. Sorry, Patrick. Let's get into it. Okay, so back to you guys reading. I do think that both of you guys, again, y'all have your own things going on, but I just think that one of you just maybe more popular than the other person. But I don't think that neither of you have any reason to, like, y'all connection could be just the fact y'all have a lot going on for each other. Y'all have a lot in common, but you might not be everybody's cup of tea, and they might be more social, or it might be the other way around. Like, one of you guys isn't taken well by other people, but it doesn't matter. Okay, I want to see, is this person Pile 3's friend? And one of you guys could be very harsh in the way you speak. The other person could be really nice and bubbly. Okay, y'all could have, like, one person could be, like, for instance, this is, like, reminding me of me and my cousin. Like, I'm an Aries, son of the Pisces moon. And my cousin is like a Pisces sun and Aries moon. So like we are totally different in the way we communicate and express ourselves. But it's like that type of vibe, you know? Is this person Power Three's friend? Page of Wands. King of Swords, Queen of Swords. Okay. Is this person Power Three's friend? And the Judgment. Page of Swords and the Seven of Wands. With the Page of Wands, I would say, yeah, but this isn't like your best friend. This is like a friend that you need to treat accordingly, because I'm telling you, this person's, they cannot hold water. Ace of Swords. You have to watch what you tell this person. And I think this person here, you know what type of person this individual is. You know that they're reactive. You know how they are. And I also think that this is somebody here, they could be, like, they can know your family, and you probably don't want your family to know certain things. But this could be somebody that where if you don't want your family to know certain shit, you tell this person, then your family's gonna know shit you don't want them to know. I feel like this person likes to gossip a lot as well. Like I said, they talk too fucking much. I think this somebody, they don't mean you any harm. I don't think they're a bad person at all. Okay, I don't think it's any reason for you to be alarmed. This person, I think this person here is somebody that will be there for you to help you if you needed them. They will like show up for you. I think they have showed up for you before when you needed them. Like, this isn't somebody that's like untrustworthy. I think that this person here, just generally speaking, they tell their own business. This person probably overshare their own business, so you can't expect them to keep your shit near and dear to their heart, you know. This person could be immature. They could be younger than you. I would also say be mindful, because this person's partner, they might like you and try to sabotage your connection between you and them. Or this person here, they could be a good friend to you, but their partner could create distance between the connection and you and them. It's not them, it's their partner. Like, they could just be somebody that's dumb behind a nigga or dumb behind a bitch, and it's like, yeah, y'all friends, yeah, but this is somebody who's obedient to, like they're being, if they're acting funny with you right now, it's because of they're being guided by somebody else, and they're just not on there. They can't stand on their own too. This is somebody here that's a little bit, they y'all are different in the way y'all express yourselves, y'all values, and what y'all are willing to tolerate. This person here, they kind of just lack certain self, like they're very submissive to their partner, and their partner probably don't care for you. So whatever stagnancy that y'all have in y'all connection, it's because they feel like they're stood between a rock and a hard place. They don't want to choose y'all friendship over their relationship, and they don't want to choose their relationship over y'all friendship. So they're in between, and it can be awkward, which is giving Queen of Swords energy. It makes sense. It's kind of, it's giving strong Libra energy. Okay, doesn't have to be that, but take what resonates and leave the rest. Okay, so what do they know about this friendship they have with Power Three? Music and Tree of Life. What do they know about this friendship? And Hearts. I think this is something that it's gonna go with the flow. But just like a song, it's not forever. It's just like, it can last forever. It can be a memory. It can be something you true treasure. If you don't listen to the same song over and over again, I think this isn't somebody that you need to have right all the time with everything you do at every waking moment of your life. But I do think it's somebody that you can love, and they're gonna be there. And it might be like somebody that you have over for family events, like Thanksgiving, Christmas, something like that, birthday party, something like that. You know, you don't have to exclude this person from shit. You just have to be strategic with how you deal with this person. Because again, they're showing up somebody that's very sweet. They love you. They care about you. I just think this person here, they could be very childlike. And I think this is something that it's a lighthearted friendship, you know? Go with the flow. It might evolve with something like stronger. But right now, y'all friendship is like lighthearted. This is like when you meet somebody, y'all really get along. It's like a cool-ass co-worker type shit. You know, it's not giving like, this is my day one, it's my best friend. She can know my social security number. Why I got abandoned by my mom at a bus stop at 7. She don't need to know all of that. But she can know, like, you know, she or he can know. She's simple. She'll, like, oh, I'm gonna go up the street after I'm already, like, leaving the street, up the street, you know, type shit. Because they run their mouth, like, bad, real bad. This isn't somebody you tell your relationship business about, too. Because they might give you poor advice because they're immature. But I feel like this is not somebody that intentionally gives you bad advice. I think this person's just, they're young-minded. This person could just not have the same, like, or this person might be somebody where they might not get along with your spouse. Take what resonates and leave the rest. You know, they might not get along with, like, as you get older and grow in life, y'all might not speak as much, but it don't mean this person isn't your friend. So this is what I have for you guys. I love you guys to the moon and back, and I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.